Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Finally, after a long time again, Ketu has transited into the nakshatra of Uttarashada from the nakshatra of Purvashada. No, from Shravan, as we had discussed last time, because Ketu is retrograde, so it goes from Shravan to Uttarashada and then it will go back to Sagittarius again. And now it is in the part of Capricorn. Alright, so let us discuss how to use this transit for our benefit and what are some of the things which we can do. Okay, because it is one of the very good nakshatras for beginning new things. Okay, so if you are new to the channel and if you are not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, then click the thumbs up at the end after seeing it till the last moment. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your marriage, your career, or your affair, or health, or anything else, then you can go to my website to book a reading. You will find the link to my website in the description section of this video below. Okay, and before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. So now, what is happening is, oh, do you see that at the corner? That's a gun, actually. My father used to, it's not gun, sorry, what you say, the long rifle. It's very heavy. My father used to shoot sometimes. Because somebody was asking the other day, what was that? So I just said, yeah. So Ketu is the significator of spirituality. We all know that. Actually, they say Ketu is a malefic, but in my experience, it is actually not a malefic. It is only a malefic for those people who do not have any spiritual inquisitiveness, or rather than saying inquisitiveness, any spiritual practice in their life or any desire to go to God. For those people, Ketu is the worst malefic. It is even more malefic than Rahu and Saturn and Mars and Sun. I have seen that in my experience. But for those people who are spiritually awakened, awakened doesn't mean that they are perfected beings, but at least they are having decent level of spiritual practices in their life, which they keep doing daily, alright? For example, chanting mantras, reading scriptures, going to holy places, talking to holy people, having a guru, maintaining connection with the gurus, spreading spiritual knowledge. For them, the Mahadasha or Antardashas of Ketu, Mahadasha will only be one and Antardashas will be many. So these time periods are probably the best time periods I have seen in their lives, in their horoscopes. Like recently I was seeing the horoscope of one of my very senior gurus. He was telling me that he is having some health issues. So I just told him that, can you just give me your birth details, I'll just have a look. And then I was seeing that he was undergoing his Ketu Dasha some time back. And then I had asked him that, how was this period? Then he said, those 5 years, although Ketu Dasha is more than 5 years, but within that 5 years, he said, those 5 to 6 years were the best years of my life. He said, never ever was there a time when I was so happy spiritually. But the problem is, most of the common public, most of the people in the mundane society, in the traditional materialistic society, are not awakened spiritually. So that is why they suffer very badly during the time period of Ketu. Because before you understand what Ketu is going to do in Uttarashada, you have to understand what is the agenda of Ketu. If you do not understand Ketu's agenda, then you can never understand how that planet is going to behave and what you should be doing. Okay, so Ketu's agenda is opposite of Rahu. What does it mean? Rahu says, enjoy and rule this material world. Yes, Rahu has the power to eclipse the sun and moon also. But Ketu says that, what will you do by ruling? There's nothing there, you see. You have to go beyond this world. Alright? So that is very important. So once you understand this agenda of Ketu, that you will only get happiness, ultimate happiness, okay? You can still get happiness in this world. Or rather, I would say you can still get pleasure in this world, okay? But the ultimate happiness, which is at the level of soul, is only going to be there with God when you do spiritual practices. Because Lord Krishna says in the Gita that nahanyate hanye mane sharire, that the soul does not it actually does not take birth, it does not die, nothing happens. Everything which is happening externally is of the body. But we are spirit souls. We are on a material journey here. People say, you are on a spiritual experience. No, it is not like that. Currently, we are spirit souls, but we are having a material experience. And we need to dovetail that experience towards spirituality. Okay. Then we are in line with the original nature. As one of my gurus says that, machli pani mein aa gayi. The fish is back to the waters. So then what happens? The fish feels very natural. So spirituality and our connection to the divine is very natural for us. But because of materialistic conditioning, we have forgotten that, you see. And spiritual things seem to be very artificial for us. That is why people tell me that, oh, I go to this place, holy place, but I don't feel very much interest in it. Okay? I don't feel like going actually. So what to do? Should I stop going? No, keep going. You will start getting interest. Because you need to fan the spark which is there inside you. Okay, so now the agenda of Ketu is to tell you that you will be happy provided you look towards the divine. So that means whenever Ketu's time period comes, we need to undergo rigorous spiritual practices. Otherwise, what will happen is it is trying to pull us that side, and then we are resisting. No. Then we suffer. But if it is pulling that side and we do not resist the change, we go that side, then it's like zoop. We will be the happiest person alive in this planet. Which means that whenever Ketu is coming as per Dasha, or if any in any house Ketu is transiting, we have to do spiritual practices pertaining to that house or in general. And especially now, because Ketu has changed the Nakshatra. And now it has already gone to Uttarashada. Because of that, what happens is, now we will realize, see, I had made a video on Shravan, Ketu's transit in Shravan. In that I said that we should sit and silently think of what practices we need to do, and then silent meditation, then chanting mantras, these are very important. But now, when it is entering Uttarashada, we need to do it more seriously. More committedly, more diligently, because Uttarashada is a Sthira Nakshatra. Sthira Nakshatra means whatever you start during that time gets continued for very long time. So the problem with Sthira Nakshatras is if you are behaving negligently, that negligence also gets carried on to eternity. So that is why I tell people, if you are not sure about something, do not start it on a Sthira Nakshatra, because then that confusion also gets carried away for eternity. We don't want that, right? But if we are fixed, if we are sure, then we should start it in Sthira Nakshatras. And Uttarashada is one of those nakshatras which shows the ultimate declaration of victory. And then when victory is obtained, then there is consolidation of victory which happens in this nakshatra. And then finally we go to Shravan. But now what is happening is, because Ketu is retrograde, it is going from Shravan to Uttarashada. So the first thing that we need to take care is, we do not see, when Ketu goes into a particular nakshatra, we can get a conception of that nakshatra in a headless way, which means that we can feel that we had recently had some great achievement in life, or something big might have happened which now we might feel is useless. Especially check in your horoscope where Ketu is transiting now. Recently, it could have happened, because see, Uttarashada is the declaration of victory. So it can happen that suppose Ketu is transiting your 7th house, for example, I am just saying. Then it could have happened that means suppose you are a Capricorn Lagna. Then it could have happened that you got a feeling that if you are a Cancer Lagna, that Ketu is transiting in your 7th house, then you could have got a feeling that there is something related to relationships which I conquered. But because Ketu is headless, you might start feeling that victory is useless actually. that can happen. That has happened with many people I know, and with me especially. Wherever Ketu is transiting, wherever Capricorn is falling in your chart, just have a look at that. So for Cancer ascendants, it will be the 7th house. For Capricorn ascendants, it will be the Lagna. Your whole life, your intellectual thought process, your inner disposition. You might feel that I'm becoming more and more headless. That can happen. Or you can have a conception of victory which is actually not victory. Because when you are headless, you can feel that, oh, everything is mine. Everything here, this is also mine, that is also mine. That can happen. I've seen that happening. But the problem is, all these headless features of Ketu gets nullified when we take to spirituality. Because why Ketu is headless? Because Ketu actually tells us that without spirituality, we are roaming like a headless person. Have you seen a person who is headless? You will never see, because then the person will die. That is our situation in this material world, that we are simply existing, we are not living. Should I repeat? We are only existing, we are not living. So don't exist, start living. Should I repeat? Don't exist, start living. And put the head. And what is the head? Head is, Uttarashada also has relation to Ganesh and to elephants. And you know that Ganesha, his head was cut by Lord Shiva. Yes, we all know that story. But here, if you try to connect both the stories, you will understand that we need a head actually. And what is that head? Head is nothing but direction. Now there's the head is always there. Rahu is the head, but Rahu is going in wrong places. Rahu is not going where it should go. It is going in the opposite direction. That is why it is opposite of Jupiter. Jupiter says, go this side. Rahu says, no, I'll go that side. And we all know which planets get Digbali in the Lagna. Yes, those planets are Jupiter and Mercury. So whenever we are confused, we should go and take suggestions from our gurus, from our superiors who are in our spiritual domain. In the parampara, we should always go and take suggestions from them. And we should also read the scriptures. Okay, so now is the time when we should take to reading of the scriptures, especially the Gita and scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam, where we will see how great personalities like Prithu Maharaj, like Dhruva Maharaj, my God, beautiful stories. Dhruva Maharaj, he wanted a kingdom greater than the kingdom of his great-grandfather. Who was his great-grandfather? Write it down in the comments. And then Lord Vishnu appeared, and later on what Lord Vishnu gave him. If you know that, then write it in the comments. Or if you don't know, and if you want me to make another video on Dhruva Maharaj, which is one of my favorite topics, then please let me know in the comments. I will try my best to make a video. Okay, so these characters are there. Then Maharaj Nimi is there. How he met the Nava Yogendras. My God, who are the Nava Yogendras? Write it in the comments if you know. And then you can read scriptures like the Mahabharat. You see, you have great personalities like Bhishma Pitama. You have personalities like Yamraj, who came as Yudhishthir and as Vidur. Yes. Two personalities were none other than Yamraj himself. Vidura and Yudhishthir Maharaj himself. Yudhishthir is Dharmaraj. Maharishi Vyas is there. Lord Krishna is there himself. Yes. We can read all the scriptures, and by that we can get a head and get freedom from this headlessness of Ketu. Otherwise, what will happen? We will go around to every place, and we will be putting our flag. Yes, this is the place we have captured, because Ketu also represents the flag. So we should, now it doesn't mean that we do not go on putting our flags, but we should know where to put the flag. And that we will only know when we take to spiritual processes and chant mantras, but specifically read scriptures, because that will give us good direction in life. All right, so I will give a link to one of the too many books which you can read, and one of the books, the Bhagavad Gita, which is there in Amazon, that link also I'll give. It will be there below in the description section. And that book is from the Madhva Sampradaya, Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, and there are many other such books which I am planning to give in future descriptions of my videos. But they are from the Sri Sampradaya, and some of the books, there are commentaries of other acharyas. Like in the Madhva tradition, we have Madhvacharya's commentary. Then we also have Sri Bhas in the Sri Vaishnav tradition. Also, there are other books from Ramanujacharya, and there are so many acharyas in that line, but I am unable to find it. All right, So as of now, the link to Bhagavad Gita, I am just giving it. And if you do not have it, you can get a copy for yourself. It is available in India and in all other places. And apart from that, if you also have your gurus, you can go and ask them suggestions and solutions. And by that, you will realize that Ketu is actually not a malefic. It is actually a benefic. You will understand that. And I'm not just saying to get more viewership or to get more subscribers that I'm making every planet good. No, it's not like that. Why will a planet want you to suffer? They never want you to suffer. But the only problem is when we do things which are not in line with what they want us to know, then there's the problem, you see. So before you say Ketu is a malefic, ask yourself this question. Have you done what Ketu wants you to do? If you have not done that, wow, it's the worst of all malefics. Alright? So read the scriptures, take the divine knowledge and get ahead for yourself. If you get, then give ahead to me also. Alright, so that is it from my side. And yes, I will be making the Jupiter transit into Scorpio video for each of the 12 Lagnas in Hindi also. So that video will also be coming. Okay. And I have also written a book recently. I will make a short video on that later also. Okay. Until next time, if you like this video, click the thumbs up. And if you're new, then please subscribe. And if you have not watched my other videos, then please watch them. And also watch the series on series which I had recorded with James Brasser. This weekend I'll also be uploading the next part. And what else? If you want a consultation, then go to my website. You'll find the link to the website in the description section of this video below. Okay, until next time, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. Okay, bye bye. See you. We'll be right back.